going to edit it. Right?
San Diego State researchers collected data from Twitter, Facebook, and websites to accurately predict the outcome of the most recent presidential election. And that's not all. Joining me to talk about how they use social media to predict the future are my guests, Dr. Deepak Gupta, Distinguished Professor of Political Science, and Dr. Ming So, Professor of Geography at SDSU, both of you. Thank you so much for being here. Professor Gupta, can you give us an overview sort of how this Mapping Ideas project works?
You know, if you think about it, ideas spread through the world, and they always take definite paths from fashion to political extremism. For ideas, for good or bad, they spread through the world. This project is designed to capture how and why they spread, and what does it mean for the rest of us?
And Dr. So, your research, you were able to capture this via, well, first, you were able to capture it via social media, correct?
Yes.
Okay, what types of social media?
We use Twitter currently because Twitter is the most open access format. We can write a program to access hundreds of thousands of tweets every single hours. Without the program.
Yeah. And bringing you lots of data. And part of that data that you used it to track and predict the spread of whooping cough this past fall here in 2012 across the nation. So let's take a look at this map that you actually were able to produce because of it. What are we looking at right now?
So the project collected over 1,000 websites containing the whooping cough, the keyword. And we are aggregate those websites using their geolocation. So now you see on the map is the red color indicate the website is aggregate in the city, which talking about whooping cough. So you can say that this city is actually very intensive discussion about the topic of whooping cough. And we realizing that when we change the week, every week, different attention was falling. So you can see on 1 week, maybe the CDC announced the whooping cough alert. Everybody is talking about whooping cough in every city, but maybe the Washington State, there's a local whooping cough outbreak, and the local media were emphasizing that.
So you were able to trend, not only just trend where the what the discussion was, but there were actual cases going on there. But Dr. Gupta, what other types of activities can you track? And what I'm thinking of is hate speech, terrorism, maybe the spring uprising. Is this something that could track that?
Oh, absolutely. We were tracking, for instance, when this preacher said that he was going to burn Quran, the book Quran, and immediately it spread like wildfire. So we were tracking who were most interested in this. And we found out that there was a spot in Topeka, Kansas, where there was a hot spot. We wanted to know why. And we found out that there was another small church that had started, they were saying that they were going to do the same thing. So we can understand, for instance, when Osama bin Laden was killed, you could see it's lighting up in so many parts. During the Arab Spring, you could see the countries that are being affected, where people are talking about these issues.
One of the goals of this project, I understand, is to be able to sort of predict how certain regions will accept the introduction of new ideas. So, Dr. So, let me start with you. Are you able to do that either politically or how does that work that you could predict a certain region, let's say, like Kansas, might be more open?
What
ideas.
We do is the reason that the values we can correlate it to the data we collect from the Twitter, social media webpage to the actual census data. So we don't know that this city, the population profile, the racial or gender profile, and we have all found a correlation between the answer opinion with their profile. So that's why we try to create a model.
All right. Well, unfortunately, we're out of time, and there's a lot more information on our website, kpbs.org. So Dr. Deepak Gupta and Dr. Ming So, thanks so much for giving us a little insight of what you do.
Thank you very much. You're welcome.